Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Muhammad Yusuf. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the UAE President, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan, following the issuance of an Emiri decree appointing His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan as Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. His Majesty the King wished the UAE President good health and happiness to continue leading his country's development march to meet the aspirations of the brotherly UAE people for further progress and prosperity under His Highness's wise leadership. His Majesty also congratulated the Abu Dhabi Crown Prince on his appointment, wishing him success in serving his country and contributing to its continued progress and prosperity. His Majesty also sent a similar cable to the UAE President on the appointment of the UAE Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of the Presidential Court, Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan, as UAE Vice President, alongside the Vice President, Prime Minister and Ruler of Dubai, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, on the appointments of His Highness Sheikh Hazza' bin Zayed Al Nahyan and His Highness Sheikh Tahnoon bin Zayed Al Nahyan as Deputy Rulers of Abu Dhabi. His Majesty wished the newly appointed officials success in serving their country and people. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received at Sakhir Palace in the presence of the personal representative of His Majesty the King, His Highness Sheikh Abdullah bin Hamad Al Khalifa, a number of citizens from the capital governorate to congratulate His Majesty on the holy month of Ramadan. The citizens greeted His Majesty the King, wishing him many happy returns on the occasion and the kingdom progress and prosperity under His Majesty's wise leadership. They expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty for the royal support to the capital governorate and His Majesty's keenness on meeting the needs and aspirations of its citizens. His Majesty welcomed the guests, expressing appreciation for their noble sentiments and their sincere wishes, lauding the role played by the people of the governorate in the development of Bahrain and their continuous contributions in all development fields. His Majesty noted that the virtues of the holy month of Ramadan, in which the values of communication, harmony, compassion and the exchange of fraternal visits are enhanced through the Ramadan councils that have distinguished the people of Bahrain throughout their history. His Majesty added that one of the most important pillars of the national development is what unites the honorable citizens of Bahrain and their solidarity that stems from the true religion of Islam and the kingdom's heritage. His Majesty affirmed that the Bahraini citizen will always remain the foundation of development and that Bahrain places at the forefront of its priorities the promotion of a decent life for its citizens at various levels. His Majesty also expressed pride in the awareness and passion of the citizen to serve, develop and enhance the status of the kingdom. His Majesty wished that the holy month of Ramadan be a month of goodness and blessings for everyone and to perpetuate the blessings of security, safety, prosperity and stability for the kingdom and its people.
Thank you. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى آل خليفة ملك البلاد المعظم حفظه الله ورعاه، أصحاب السمو، أصحاب المعالي والسعادة، أيها الحضور الكريم، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. ويتجدد اللقاء في هذه الأيام المباركة حرصاً منكم يا صاحب الجلالة على ترسيخ نهج التواصل والتآلف بين الجميع في وطن الجميع. وخير ما نبدأ به تلاوة عطرة من القرآن الكريم يتلوها على مسامعنا القارئ علي صلاح عمر.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وإذ قال إبراهيم رب اجعل هذا البلد آمنا واجنبني وبني أن نعبد الأصنام. رب إنهن أضللن كثيرا من الناس فمن تبعني فإنه مني ومن عصاني فإنك غفور رحيم. ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك المحرم ربنا ليقيموا الصلاة فاجعل أفئدة من الناس تهوي إليهم وارزقهم من الثمرات لعلهم يشكرون. ربنا إنك تعلم ما نخفي وما نعلن وما يخفى على الله من شيء في الأرض ولا في السماء. الحمد لله الذي وهب لي على الكبر إسماعيل وإسحاق إن ربي لسميع الدعاء. رب اجعلني مقيم الصلاة ومن ذريتي ربنا وتقبل دعاء. ربنا اغفر لي ولوالدي وللمؤمنين يوم يقوم الحساب. صدق الله العظيم.
كلمة أهالي محافظة العاصمة يلقيها نيابة عنهم السيد تقي محمد البحر.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
After that, Taqi Mohammed Bahana delivered a speech on behalf of the people of the capital government in which he congratulated His Majesty the King on the advent of the holy month of Ramadan, as well as the people of Bahrain and the Arab and Islamic nations. He expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for the reception and praised the achievements that were made during the prosperous era of His Majesty the King following the reform project of His Majesty. He praised the pioneering status of the Kingdom of Bahrain in all fields and hailed all the achievements on all levels that were made thanks to the wise vision of His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa. He lauded the continuous progress witnessed in Bahrain and His Majesty's keenness to ensure high living standards to citizens. He hailed His Majesty's role in spreading the values of peace and coexistence in order to achieve sustainable development and enhance international peace. He commended the recent historic visit of His Holiness Pope Francis to Bahrain and participating in the Bahrain Dialogue Forum East and West for Peaceful Coexistence with the participation of the Grand Imam of Al-Azhar, Dr. Ahmed Al-Tayyib, in addition to Bahrain's hosting the 146th Inter-Parliamentary Union Assembly. He praised the role of the capital governorate in engaging with citizens and meeting their needs, as well as implementing pioneering initiatives such as Health Cities Program, Manama Entrepreneurship Week, Voluntary Work Document, and Green Capital Project. He also praised the role of the Minister of Interior, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa, in enhancing communication among citizens. He wished His Majesty the King good health and happiness to continue the march of progress of the kingdom.
تمتزج فيه مشاعر المحبة والتكاتف والانتماء والولاء والعرفان وصورة تختزل معاني الوفاء والتلاحم بين قائد مسيرتنا المباركة وأبناء شعبه الأوفياء فلكم منا يا صاحب الجلالة عظيم الشكر وبالغ الامتنان على شرف اللقاء وكرم الاستقبال الذي عهدناه دوما من جلالتكم حفظكم الله. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، إن هذا اللقاء الميمون يعد فرصة نستحضر فيها مسيرة الإنجاز التي تحققت منذ تولي جلالتكم مقاليد الحكم، حيث كان مشروعكم الإصلاحي الشامل أولى لبنات هذه المسيرة المباركة، ومنذ ذلك اليوم أصبحت البحرين رائدة وآخذة بزمام المبادرة في العديد من خطوات التغيير والتطوير في كافة مناحي الحياة، لنشهد مكتسبات ومنجزات كبيرة متلاحقة على مختلف الأصعدة. واليوم نقف بكل فخر واعتزاز لنلامس التقدم والتطور في شتى المجالات التنموية من خلال المشروعات التي تم تدشينها وتنوعت بين القطاعات الإسكانية والتنمية الحضرية، ومن خلال المشروعات الصحية والسياحية وغيرها من المجالات، والتي تحققت بفضل من الله ثم بإرادة قائد حكيم يحمل رؤية مستنيرة لتنمية وطننا الغالي، وبدعم مستمر من حكومتكم الرشيدة، وذلك برئاسة صاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد رئيس مجلس الوزراء حفظه الله، والتي ترجمت الأهداف والرؤى الملكية السامية لجلالتكم وحولتها إلى واقع يعيشه أبناء هذا الوطن أمنا وأمانا وتقدما وازدهارا. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، لم تقتصر مسيرة جلالتكم المباركة على تحقيق نواحي التطور والتنمية المستدامة التي يعيشها المواطن والمجتمع البحريني في مختلف مجالات الحياة وعلى امتداد هذه الأرض الطيبة، بل تجسدت عظمتها كذلك في إعلاء وإرساء القيم السامية والمبادئ والأسس الإنسانية. ففي خضم ما يشهده العالم في يومنا هذا من تعالي أصوات التطرف والدعوة إلى الفرقة أتت رؤيتكم المستنيرة بالسير على نهج ترسيخ السلام وقيم التسامح والتعايش، وفقاً لقناعة جلالتكم الراسخة بأنها السبيل نحو النهوض بالمجتمعات وتحقيق التنمية المستدامة وتعزيز السلام العالمي. فكان لاستقبال جلالتكم قداسة البابا فرانسيس بابا الفاتيكان وفضيلة الإمام الأكبر شيخ الأزهر هنا على أرض المحبة والتعايش والسلام، ورعايتكم الكريمة لفعاليات ملتقى البحرين للحوار حوار الشرق والغرب من أجل التعايش الإنساني، الرسالة الواضحة للعالم قاطبة بأن البحرين كانت وستظل مهد السلام وملتقى الثقافات وموطن التسامح والتعايش والمحبة. كذلك دعوتكم الجمعية العامة 146 للاتحاد البرلماني الدولي إلى إقرار اتفاقية دولية لتحريم خطابات الكراهية الدينية والطائفية والعنصرية بجميع صورها، والذي تبناها الاتحاد البرلماني الدولي من خلال إعلان المنامة، فهنيئاً لنا بقائد أعلى القيم الإنسانية وأبرز معاني ومفاهيم التسامح والتعايش السلمي بين الأديان والمجتمعات. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، ولا يفوتنا أيضاً جميعاً أن نثني على الدور الذي تطلع به محافظة العاصمة في التواصل الفعال بين المواطنين والمقيمين وتلمس احتياجاتهم على أرض الواقع وتنفيذ المبادرات الرائدة التي تصب في تنمية المجتمع والارتقاء بمستوى المعيشة، ومن أبرزها برنامج المدن الصحية وأسبوع المنامة لريادة الأعمال ووثيقة العمل التطوعي ومشروع العاصمة الخضراء. كما نشهد في هذا الصدد بمتابعة وتوجهات الفريق أول معالي الشيخ راشد بن عبد الله آل خليفة وزير الداخلية حفظه الله للمحافظين بتعزيز التواصل بين المحافظات والمواطنين لتحقيق الأمن المجتمعي وترسيخ العلاقة التكاملية مع الجهات المختلفة وتفعيل الشراكة المجتمعية لما فيه صالح الوطن والمواطنين. وفي الختام نتضرع إلى المولى عز وجل أن ينعم على جلالتكم بطول العمر وأن يديم عليكم منفور الصحة والعافية وأن يحفظكم لمواصلة مسيرة الخير والنماء والإصلاح لمملكتنا العزيزة، مؤكدين لجلالتكم أن أهالي المحافظة لما ما تزال على العهد يبادلونكم الحب والولاء والإخلاص والطاعة. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة، بكم ترتجي البحرين إعلاء شأنها وأبناؤها درع لكم وجنوده، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
أما الآن
After that, poet Muhammad Hadi al-Halwachi delivered a poem on the occasion.
Assalamu alaikum. قف نبدي التحية والسلام قف نبدي التحية والسلام لمن أحيت أبوته الوئام لمن ملك القلوب بنبل طبع وطيب فاق في الطيب الخزام ومن أحيت سماحته قلوبا عليها الدهر بالأزمات ضاما ومن مسحت يداه دموع ثكل ومن غطت عباءته الأيام ومن بظلاله ابتسمت وجوه عليها الحزن خيم واستدام حنانا منه قد أبدى حنانا ومر اليتم قد أنسى اليتامى ومن ضاءت بحكمته الليالي ومن ضاءت بحكمته الليالي ومن قشعت مكارمه الظلاما أبا سلمان لم أنطق جزافا ولا نمقت عن جهل كلاما فلولا أنت ما نطقت حروفي ولا انتظم القصيد ولا استقاما ولولا أنت ما سطرت بيتا رقيق الحرف ينتظم انتظاما لأن الشعر يبحث عن بريق ينير له الطريق إذا تعامى ويعشق كل من بلغ المعالي ويعشق في مسيرته الكرامى ولست أرى سواك إذا ادلهمت طريق الشعر أو صعبت مراما لأنطق ما أشاء من المعاني وأختصر الطريق وإن تراما كأني قد اتخذت بها ركوبا وصيرت الحروف لها لجاما وصيرت القصيد بساط ريح أطير عليه بدءا واختتاما وإن صعبت علي ذكرت فعلا كريما منك قد بلغ السناما وكي تنقاد لي طوعا وتلقي إلي سحاب قافية تهاما بكم يا سيدي يزدان شعري بكم يا سيدي يزدان شعري وباسمكم اتخذت به وساما وباسمكم لبست وشاح فخر وصرت بشعر حبكم إماما وأطرب كلما أنشدت شعرا بحبك منه أسكرت المداما شربت بحبكم كأس القوافي شربت بحبكم كأس القوافي وكأسا قد سقيت بها الندامة وأخرى قد شربت بها قليلا لأقفو بعض آثار القدامى لأني قد عرفتك بحر جود متى ما يأته العاني تطاما يمينا في يمينك ألف بحر بموج الجود تلتطم التطاما فجد يا سيدي لفتا بقرب تعلق في محبتكم وهاما فجد يا سيدي لفتا بقرب تعلق في محبتكم وهاما عرفتك يا أبا سلمان قلبا كبيرا قد حوى همما عظاما ورأيا فيصلا في كل أمر تحاكي حد شفرته الحسامة وميزانا إذا ما اختل أمر لفعل الخير يحتكم احتكاما وحسنا كلما طرقت خطوب لهيبته الصعاب غدت لماما فبشرى بالصيام وشهر صوم كريم عم بالبشر الأنامى فنعم العبد من بسطت يداه به وبليله أحيا القيامة وبادر للفضائل غير وان ولم يسرف وكان به قواما وتهنئة أخص بها هماما ولي العهد
من حفظ الذمام أبا عيسى الذي شخصت إليه عيون الناس حباً واحتراماً، ومن جارى بهمته المعالي ولم يشك التململ والسؤام، ومن دانت له العسرات حتى بهمته أذل له النهاما، وأخرى قد زففت بها التهاني لناصر من بهمته تسامى، فتى جاز الطموح فحاز نصرا له العلياء قد ألقت زماما، فدمت لنا أبا سلمان ذخرا ودرعا رد عادية وحاما، ودام لنا بظلكم أمان وللبحرين كل الخير داما، ودام لنا بظلكم أمان وللبحرين كل الخير داما. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
After that, the capital governor, Sheikh Rashid Abd al-Rahman al-Khalifa, presented a commemorative gift to His Majesty. On this occasion, the capital governor expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King on behalf of himself and the capital governorate people for receiving them. He stressed that this visit is an honor for all the people, affirming the keenness of His Majesty to meet with citizens in all occasions and the depth of relationships between the leader and the people. He affirmed to continue on the path of development and prosperity, which was achieved thanks to His Majesty's wise vision and the efforts of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa sent a cable of congratulations to the UAE President His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan following the issuance of an Emira decree appointing His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan as the Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi. His Royal Highness wished the UAE further progress and prosperity under the leadership of His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed. His Royal Highness sent a similar cable to the UAE President on the appointment of the UAE Deputy Prime Minister and Minister of the Presidential Court Sheikh Mansour bin Zayed Al Nahyan as UAE Vice President alongside the Vice President, Prime Minister and Ruler of Dubai, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, and on the appointment of His Highness Sheikh Hazza' bin Zayed Al Nahyan and His Highness Sheikh Tahnoon bin Zayed Al Nahyan as Deputy Rulers of Abu Dhabi. His Royal Highness wished their Highnesses success in serving the UAE and its people. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa held a telephone call with the newly appointed Crown Prince of Abu Dhabi, His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan. His Royal Highness highlighted the strength of relations between Bahrain and the UAE, which continues to receive the support of both His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa and the President of the UAE, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Zayed Al Nahyan. His Royal Highness wished His Highness Sheikh Khalid bin Mohammed success in contributing to the prosperity and development of the UAE. His Royal Highness and His Highness also discussed ways to strengthen bilateral relations to benefit both countries and their peoples. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa yesterday visited the majlises of Abdullah bin Hamad Al-Naimi, Adil Al-Ali and the chairman of the BCCI Samir Nas. His Royal Highness exchanged Ramadan blessings with the hosts and guests of the majlises. His Royal Highness highlighted the kingdom's ongoing development across a wide range of economic sectors, which is advancing in line with the kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness noted that Bahraini citizens remain at the heart of the kingdom's development plans, initiatives and strategies. He emphasized the kingdom's commitment to continue implementing economic programs that deliver for Bahraini citizens and contribute to economic growth. He noted the importance of Ramadan majlises in reinforcing Islamic and cultural values that guide and maintain bonds between the kingdom's people. His Royal Highness underscored the importance of building on the kingdom's recent positive economic indicators by advancing development efforts by implementing the 2023-2026 government special program goals, priorities, policies and initiatives to benefit Bahraini citizens. His Royal Highness further emphasized the importance of strengthening public-private partnerships across across investment projects to drive economic development. His Royal Highness noted the importance of cooperation between the executive and legislative authorities, which guided the success of economic projects that benefit the kingdom and its citizens. The Majlis host and guests expressed their gratitude to His Royal Highness for his visit and praised His Royal Highness's engagement with Bahrainis in the Ramadan Majlises. They wished Bahrain progress and prosperity under the leadership of His Majesty the King. His Royal Highness was accompanied by the Chairman of the Board of Trustees of the Isa bin Salman Educational Charitable Trust, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, the Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, and several senior officials. His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Prime Minister and Chairman of the Economic Development Board, Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, issued Edict 2 of 2023, appointing Khalid Amr Rumaihi as a member of the Board of Directors of the Bahrain Mumtalakat Holding Company until the end of the board term. An implementation of the directives of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister and based on the edict issued by His Royal Highness, the Board of Directors of Bahrain Mumtalakat Holding Company, chaired by the Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, welcomed the appointment of Khalid Rumaihi to the company's Board of Directors and the appointment of Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa as CEO of Mumtalakat effective May 1, 2023. The Board of Directors affirmed Mumtalakat's commitment to continue to grow and diversify its portfolio, which will increase Mumtalakat's contribution to the national economy in line with the goals of the National Development Vision of His Majesty the King and the guidance of His Royal Highness. The board praised Khalid Rumaihi's contributions to Mumtalakat's positive performance during his tenure as Mumtalakat's CEO and congratulated Sheikh Abdullah bin Khalifa Al Khalifa for his appointment as the new CEO, wishing him success in his new role. Rumaihi expressed appreciation for the trust of His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness, which will allow him to continue serving as a member of Team Bahrain in the pursuit of the kingdom's goals. His Majesty the King's representative for Humanitarian Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Oil and Gas Holding Company, Noga Holding, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, presided over the first Board of Directors meeting of 2023. His Highness was presented with a consolidated financial statement for 2022, which highlighted the company's financial performance and efforts. This comes as Noga Holding drives its efforts to achieve the vision and goals set by the Kingdom's wise leadership. His Majesty the King and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister in the development of the oil and gas sector. His Highness praised the progress being made on the transformational national energy strategy aiming to power the ongoing development of Bahrain's economy responsibly and sustainably. His Highness commended Noga Holding and its efforts in driving efficiency and increasing productivity across the group's operating companies and pursuing its commitment towards sustainable energy through new technologies such as carbon capture, in line with the Kingdom of Bahrain's Economic Vision 2030. The board was also presented with further updates, including the approved group objectives for 2023, the financial strategy, and upcoming projects. His Majesty the King's representative for Humanitarian Work and Youth Affairs, Chairman of the Oil and Gas Holding Company, Noga Holding, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, attended ASRI's celebration of the company's outstanding result and performance during 2022 in the presence of senior officials, the Chairman of the Board of Directors, representatives of the executive management, and a number of administrative and employees. His Highness hailed ASRI's results that indicate reaching the desired financial recovery in a way that enhances the sustainability of the development process. He noted that ASRI is continuing to achieve a sustainable future, wishing the company continued success. During the event, ASRI announced the positive results it had achieved since the launch and implementation of its long-term strategy to restructure all the company's procedures and operations in the year 2019. ASRI Chairman of the Board of Directors, Ayman Lamayed, expressed pleasure at achieving these results, which shows reaching the desired financial recovery for the company and enhances the sustainability of the development process regionally and globally. The Ministry of Foreign Affairs held a Ramadan Ghabgat in honor of ambassadors and heads of diplomatic missions and offices accredited to Bahrain in the presence of the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Dr. Abdul Latif Al-Zayani, and the Ambassador of Jordan to Bahrain, Dean of the Diplomatic Corps, Rami Al-Adwan. The Minister and the ambassadors toured the Heritage Corner organized by the Ministry in cooperation with the Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, which showcased Bahraini heritage and handicrafts. Dr. Al-Zayani expressed thanks to the ambassadors for accepting the invitation, stressing Bahrain's pride under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al-Khalifa and the government headed by His Royal Highness the Crown Prince and Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa for the ambassador's efforts in consolidating cooperation between Bahrain and their countries. The minister affirmed Bahrain's keenness on providing full support and all facilities to the diplomatic missions accredited to the kingdom to enable them to perform their diplomatic duties to the fullest extent and contribute to the success of the work in consolidating various aspects of joint cooperation between Bahrain and their countries. The ambassadors expressed thanks and gratitude to the Ministry of Foreign Affairs for organizing the event, stressing that this ongoing communication between the ministry and diplomatic missions contributes the success of the efforts of the two sides to strengthen relations of friendship and cooperation between Bahrain and their countries, wishing Bahrain continued progress and prosperity. In the presence of the chairwoman of Injaz Bahrain, Her Highness Sheikha Hassa bint Khalifa Al-Khalifa, and the Director General of Verdict Enforcement and Alternative Sentencing at the Ministry of Interior, Sheikh Khalid bin Rashid Al-Khalifa, the Directorate signed a framework agreement with Injaz Bahrain to provide programs for beneficiaries of the Open Prisons Program. The signing of the agreement comes in implementation of the directives of the Minister of Interior, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al-Khalifa, to strengthen community partnership and national belonging with various institutions and individuals of civil society. The agreement aims to develop and refine the skills of the beneficiaries of the Open Prisons Program in the field of leadership, project development, and innovation. The Directorate affirmed its endeavor to support and empower the beneficiaries develop their knowledge and professional capabilities and offering programs that are in line with the requirements of the labor market.